Hello and welcome to Tech Not Toys. I'm Tom Morell.
And I'm Suzy Taylor.
Coming up on today's show, we'll be trying out the latest and affordable HD pocket camcorders.
We'll be comparing which is the best way to get fit in the comfort of your own home using the latest technology on the Nintendo Wii. And we'll both be trying out a new take on an old classic.
With Christmas just around the corner, many people's attentions will be turned to gift ideas, and here on TNT we are going to help you by talking about some of the best ideas for every price range.
Now, one of the best gadgets of the last few years has been the Nintendo Wii, which has been one of the fastest selling consoles, outnumbering PS3 and Xbox 360 sales. With the market for approachable, intuitive games pretty much sewn up, Nintendo have set the crosshairs on the home fitness market, with games such as Wii Fit Plus and EA Sports Active. But can exercise games actually replace good old-fashioned exercise, such as the physical activity of the gym?
To find out, we were given both games to play, and here's how we got on.
Tom! Come on!
Okay! Here we go!
What do you look like? Please tell me that's not what you normally do in the gym.
Yeah.
Didn't we have fun, Susie? What a fun day that was. And didn't I look great?
Well, we did have fun, but not because you looked great. You looked a bit silly.
Oh, I thought I looked all right. I didn't think I looked that bad.
Surely you don't wear that to the gym on a normal day.
No, I didn't. I think it's a bit of an old PE kit my mum dug out for me, to be honest.
I think she was having a little bit of a laugh as well.
I can admit that I did look a bit ridiculous.
But you know what? That's the great thing about the Wii Fit and the EA Sports games, because you can wear whatever you want. You can do it in the comfort of your own home, which is fab, isn't it?
Yeah, that is fab. I mean, we were a bit unfortunate because we did have the crew around us, and it was a little bit uncomfortable sometimes getting into those awkward and funny positions, especially with these guys around us.
Things were a little bit tight.
They certainly were, yes. But yeah, you're completely right. I think it makes people feel very comfortable, doing these activities within the comforts of their own home, which is a great benefit of playing these games, I reckon.
So which one was your favourite game then, do you think?
My favourite game was probably the Wii Fit Plus. I thought that was fantastic. It really kept me captivated and the graphics were fantastic. The EA Sports, it lacked a little bit with the graphics and I wasn't quite gripped, and I found it very unresponsive, in fact.
See, I found both of them equally as good. I couldn't make my mind up, because I just think the Wii Fit is great for families, and then the EA Sports one was great for, if you're on your own and you need to, do a bit of a fitness workout at home. So I find it really hard to choose one out of the two.
Oh, really? I've got an out and out one, you see, because I thought the EA Sports, it wasn't really doing what I was really telling it to. You see, I was pulling those perfect bicep curls with that elastic rubber band.
Did she say rubbish?
Yeah, she kept on telling me I was doing them really badly, and it was just so frustrating, because honestly, my personal trainer says I do them absolutely perfectly.
Tom,
he tells me I'm fantastic.
Course.
That woman on the game, no, it was completely different.
I loved those bicep curls, because I found with that, then with the fun of the flapping game, my arms were really aching the next day, which is great. That's what you want from a workout, isn't it?
Completely. With the Wii Fit, I thought it was fantastic having that board on the floor.
Brilliant,
and
yeah.
you were literally flapping your wings up and down to control your character to fly. I thought that was absolutely brilliant, mind-boggling stuff.
And then the skateboarding one as well. I wonder if it gives you a good impression of what it would be actually like to do it, in real life. So I loved it.
I can see you being a kind of skater girl now.
I know, I am. I think I'm a bit of a skateboard chick.
Yeah, I think so too. I think so too. But tell me, Susie, out of both of them, which one would you go for?
Well, I can imagine me and my family playing on the Wii Fit for Christmas, being really competitive, nearly killing each other. So it's definitely on my Christmas wish list.
We'll put it on mine as well. Susie, I've got some other things to show you. These consoles here are definitely what I'm going to be spending my Christmas savings on. Yes, that's right. The Xbox 360 and the PlayStation 3, these consoles are designed and marketed towards the more seasoned gamers and have recently had Modern Warfare 2 and Assassin's Creed 2 released. Both games were huge hits, selling more than 2 million copies worldwide, which in itself shows an amazing appeal to a huge market.
But hasn't the Wii sold and is still selling more consoles than the 360 and the PS3?
Yes, you would be right there, Suzy. These consoles are aimed to the more hardcore gamers, such as myself, with 15 to 18 rated titles, while the Wii can appeal to anyone as a more family-friendly type of console. My nan, who is 70, yes, that's right, 70, she plays it as well.
What a cool nan.
Yeah, she's great. She's just like me, Suzy. Having said that, with the recent price drops combined with good old-fashioned Boxing Day sales, it could be the time to take the plunge and buy one of these consoles yourself.
So what about for people like me who don't want to blow up zombies or mutilate aliens?
Come on, Suzy, you know you want to, really.
Not really.
Well, there are games available for the PS3 and 360 that are more suited to the casual gamer, but you may well be better off getting the Wii or Nintendo DS if this is you. Plus, the DS has the added benefit of being portable.
Ah, yeah. Well, it's not uncommon now to see people kind of playing on the DS on the tube, or kids in the playground, you know, for lunch, during their break times. You know, it's a great way for brain training.
I would, yeah. There are all sorts of in-depth role-playing games like the Pokemon and Final Fantasy series, which have been so popular and have both spawned movies. There are also loads of highly interactive, simpler games such as Star Boutique or World of Zoo. Similar to the Wii, there are also health-related games such as brain training for your mind and active health for your body.
Thanks for that, Tom.
You can always count on me, can't you?
So what about this then? Now this is the iPhone. Now it's the handheld games console. They have to compete with my phone. I mean, look at the quality of the graphics. You see them? Something that's originally designed to take calls. Now, some of the games are even free. I mean, how about this for a Christmas gift? A phone and a console all in one. You can now buy gift cards for the App Store as well as iTunes for anyone you know with one of these, which is quite a lot of people. Yeah, not you.
I'll have one, please, Suzy.
Now, for years, handheld games and toys have been all the rage. The Rubik's Cube, Game Boy, etc. And most of them have seen some form of modernisation. Now, the Bop It is no exception, with a new feature aptly named...
Shout It!
And it's available now.
This toy is absolutely fantastic. It's been around for over a decade and has evolved into a party favourite for family and for friends.
It can also be irritatingly addictive, like Tom.
No, like you.
With, either on your own or in a group.
And with it coming up to Christmas, the new Bop It is the top 10 wish list for all ages. Bop It is available from all good toy and gadget shops for around £20, and it's definitely a must-have stocking filler.
I've had enough of it already.
Give it to me then, let me have a go. I want to go, it's my turn.
I've had enough of that. Anyway, with high definition exploding onto our screens from every possible angle, we decided to review some of the best, but more importantly, cost-effective HD pocket camcorders. Now, these video recorders are extremely popular, and the majority record images in 720p, which makes for highly detailed viewing. It's gone from being an expensive, bulky luxury to an affordable, handheld, practical device. Now, prices start from around £80, depending on the model and specification. These kinds of cameras are best used for family events and holidays because they are pocket-sized. Now, as you can see, I'm going to see if this will work. There we go, I've got it. See, even for the not so technically minded, you can get it to work. Now, this model is the ApeTech Pocket DV AHD 100 and costs around £100. Now, for your money, you get a reasonable camera with two special effects modes and several recording formats. It can also be used as a still camera, which I think is great. It doubles up with up to 8 megapixels. Now, we found that when we were testing it, that it was easy to use, which is good because the instructions aren't that great, to be honest with you. It's lightweight, so ladies, you can pop it into your... hello, give us a wave. You can pop it into your handbag. And it's not too bulky, so, you know, guys, you can pop it into your pocket. It doesn't come with... It doesn't actually come with a memory card, But you can pick one of these up for about £20. So you get what you pay for, basically. Now, if quality is what you're after, like if you're a young Steven Spielberg, you may want to shop around for other cameras. However, if you want a cheap, affordable camera for holiday memories or even a night out, these pocket camcorders are definitely worthwhile. And now, it's time for that part of the show where we look at what is happening in the world of technology with Crazy Tom.
Oh, thank you, Susanna. We start the news today with the leaked information that the Amazon e-book reader Kindle may become available in the United Kingdom. Currently, it is imported specially from the United States. Its clunky, ugly shell may have prevented it from taking off, which is probably a good thing, as next year... That's right, you may have heard about it, and it's still not been confirmed, but rumours keep getting stronger and stronger. The masters of design at Apple have been at it again. And the iTablet appears to be on its way. Using all of Apple's touchscreen and iPhone technology, it will bring a whole new dimension to the household media, and speculators are assuming it will be around 10 inches long. One of the main selling points will be the App Store, with many more possibilities, including an e-book store, as well as a daily newspaper. It could literally kill the daily newspapers as we know it today. Speaking of Apple, Nokia may well have just started a war with them. Yes, you heard it here first. With Apple, the current frontrunners of practical touchscreen technology, it comes as a surprise that Nokia has patented the ability to put a pressure-sensitive touchscreen on mobile phones. This feature would add a whole other dimension to the touchscreen experience. At this stage, it is unclear as to whether it is simply a patent to stop Apple running too far ahead with their technology, or if they are actually planning on doing something with it. As well, the UK version of Netflix Love Film has announced that it will soon be streaming to a mystery device. Insiders assume this will either be the PlayStation 3 or the Xbox 360. And with more people having a console connected to their television than a computer, this could really launch the online download rentals of movies. If it is Xbox, this would add to the recent addition of Sky, allowing users to download premium content to their console, with some of it even being for free. Right then, that's all we have for this week. Back to you, Susanna.
So that's it for the show. But now you have the opportunity to win all of the gadgets. Yes, that's all of the gadgets featured on today's show. Just answer this simple question. Come on, Tommy boy.
What did Suzy find irritatingly addictive? Was it A, the Nintendo Wii, B, the Bop-It, or was it C, the HD camera?
Now, all you have to do is text the answer to 98851. Terms and conditions apply. The closing date is the 14th of December 2009. Entries made after this date will not be eligible, but may still be charged.
So watch out for that, guys. The answer to last week's question was, what did I like to watch? And the obvious answer was... Blu-ray films.
Yeah, not like some of the texts we got in were a bit.
Yeah, they were. Yeah, I don't think they really know me, do they, Susie? Blu-ray films. Good idea for Christmas presents,
yeah,
I tell you.
Yeah, well, lucky.
Well, I tell you who doesn't have to worry about that. Sarah Wilkinson from Nuneaton, well done to you, was the lucky winner of the selection of Blu-ray movies and a year's subscription to Love Film. So you'll be sorted for the Christmas period.
Yeah, and Sarah, sleep with your eyes open, because I'm so jealous. I love watching Blu-ray films. I might come and pinch them off you.
Oh, she does. She certainly does. I know all about that. You have everything perfectly set up at your place, don't you, Susie?
Yep.
With that surround sound and your coffee table perfectly positioned for your popcorn.
Yeah, well, maybe one day you'll be lucky enough, and I'll invite you round, but probably not.
It's a great idea. Thank you, Susie. Anyway, that's all we have time for on this show. Tune in next time when we will be comparing ebook readers and netbooks, as well as reviewing the next generation of iMacs. Please, guys, don't miss it.
Yeah, I'm looking forward to that one. So thank you so much for watching. Make sure that you get on those phones and enter that competition. It's well worth it.
Thanks for watching, guys.
Yep,
take
we'll
care.
See you next week.
See you soon
you.
Then.
Bye.
Bye. Take your toys.